what does the end of tour feel like? It's overwhelming. It's overwhelming. I truly put so much into this show, knowing that it is never going to be performed this way ever again. It's very emotional for sure. It being my first, you know, I guess real tour with a debut album, it still feels surreal. It feels like it was a dream that maybe didn't actually happen. And I'm forever and eternally grateful to every single person. You know, I'm still in shock. And yeah, I love you, truly. Truly and honestly, I love you. And I'm so appreciative forever and ever. Mainly people that I haven't seen in so long. It's so awesome to see so many faces that I don't get to see as often as I do. So cool that I get to not only see the world, but sing and perform while doing it. And it's especially mind-blowing to look out at a crowd full of people singing your songs when they live across the globe.
Yes, we come from Mexico.
Hi, kisses from Poland.
Trust me, you might not think I saw you in the crowd. I see everyone in my crowds.
There's a sign up there.
It's so beautiful and insane to me that a song that I wrote when I felt like I was the only person on this planet, I now get to look in somebody's eyes every single night, multiple people's eyes, and see them singing those lyrics back to me, and I could never feel alone. And yeah, it's just, it's beautiful what how they've changed the meaning of a song that they feel safe with me, and that it's very, very important to us. They thought that I was wrong, but now they'll all see, they're all gonna see, that's where I'm meant to be now, they're all gonna see, it's where I'm meant to be. It's important to have good people around you no matter what. It's important to have people who support you, who understand you, who hear you. I definitely think, especially on tour when it is exhausting and long travel nights and then long show days can be a lot. So it's really important to feel supported and loved while you're on the road. On each tour, I've made such great friends and everyone has gotten along, which is also incredible.
Party shirt loadout, let's fucking go.
You know, just having people who are excited and who want to be part of something, it's important to me. And I love each and every person on my crew very deeply.
Thank you.
How would I describe my dancers? Angel and Justine, they are incredible. I don't know how I got so lucky, to be honest. I have no idea how. I was blessed with two incredible talents, but also two incredible people who I just, it, there's no words. And I think when it's unexplainable, that says enough. And they've brought life to my songs that I didn't know could exist. I'm so grateful for the both of them. But, you know, even during boy shit, when we're jumping around and being crazy, I value and cherish those moments so, so much. They are so much fun. Cause I don't speak boy, no. I don't speak.
The thing is about her music is that it makes me feel like powerful. It
really helps me feel at peace. I feel loved when I listen to her music.
Pulls the words right out of my brain and just like puts it into music.
A lot of her songs are relatable for life experiences I've been through.
Connect her music with like healing and just happiness. I don't know, it just makes me feel like, it just feels like a hug, you know?
I've been listening to her for 6 years. And to be here tonight really makes me really happy.
She's just so vulnerable and she just puts her heart in everything she does, and I love that, so.
Dealing also with all of the social media and all of the, I guess, sometimes hate that sometimes she might receive, I think her songs are a really powerful way of connecting emotionally.
And I truly think that she's really wants to share with us few things that we maybe can't share when you're speaking, for example, with her or something like this. It's a really different way to share emotions like she does here right now.
I love meeting my fans so much. Yeah, it, especially now since we've all been separated for so long, meeting them has felt so, so good. I am where I am because of these people. They support me and they know me, and they're more like friends than they are fans. And you know, I'm very lucky, and I am very grateful. So we do two meet and greets every day. We do a personal meet and greet where I take a photo with somebody and meet them and give them a big hug. Get on stage and I answer some questions, which I came up with that idea because a lot of my fans really like when I go live and talk to them and answer questions and stuff. So I figured a great way to interact with them in person would be to do a fun little Q&A before the show.
Thank you like, so seriously, much. You are so. She designed the merch. Literally posted like on Twitter, this is my concept for like Madison Beer's merch, and I saw it. I loved it. Yeah.
My preparation for shows isn't too serious. I think that's something that I've had to learn was I'm the kind of person where I need to almost pretend like I'm not performing a legit show. I'm just going on stage and, you know, this is rehearsal in order to put a good show on. Because whenever I've ever in my life hyped things up or I've gotten too psyched out about something, it ends up going wrong. So I try to just stay calm. Again, keep people around me who are positive. Just be like, oh, this is the intro. Here we go. Cause this is the fifth time I've taken you back, it's the fourth time. That I've relapsed, it's the third, second chance that I've given you for the first time. Let this be the last. Fifth time I've taken you back, it's the fourth time that I've collapsed into your arms. It's so hard, but for the best, for the first time. Let this be the last. Please, please, let this. I didn't experience this level of sadness in depth on my last tour. I think it's been 50 shows that we've done, which is just ridiculous. And I can't believe I'm saying that now that it's over. It's amazing. It's so rewarding. It's so affirming. And it just makes me want to, you know, create more and more and go on more tours, release more albums. And it's very encouraging. And, you know, honestly, I guess what I feel most at the end of a tour is the excitement for another.
Fast. See you in a sec.
The world is mad and they say I'm the crazy one. So I just stay numb and carry on. Too young to hate someone. Truth is it was never love. Your fault if you thought it was.
Totally, I'm gonna give her a big hug when she gets off stage.
Yay! Oh, God, thank you for dedication. Of course, they were so excited. Everyone gave 10 times more of a shit. I was like, yes, oh my God. Let's go!
No, yeah, I like almost cried during the last song. I was like, nope, don't do it.
My hands are so sweaty because I'm like working myself up.
You've done amazing. Think of all the people that have said that this has touched them and helped them.
That's what I'm like. I think it's.
And now you get to do it with a whole other chapter.
Whoa. Alright, I'm gonna get dressed. Bye.
I just might pray. I try to look after my mental health while on tour by setting boundaries mainly. I make sure that I'm well rested and I don't give up too much of myself every single day so that I can put on a good show, feel good about it, feel happy. You know, I think this is actually something I'm still working on. I think that when I'm in tour mode, the shows are the most important, and sometimes I can truthfully and admittedly like let my mental health slip up a bit. I'm still working on trying to understand and get to a better balance with that, but you know, I'm really, really lucky to have a lot of fans who respect me in that way. And you know, when I say, hey guys, I'm just gonna go to bed this night, they respect it, and that means a lot.
Toxic boy, I ain't even gonna try to find the G-O-O-D and goodbye. You put the over in love, put the X in next. Ain't no I in trouble, just the you since we met. Cause you're toxic boy, I ain't even gonna try to find the G-O-O-D and goodbye.
My
my patience is now setting like the sun. When my tears fall on your lap, we've just begun. Is it hot time, baby, that I'm not time? Baby, that I'm not time. Hot time, yeah. Hot time, baby, that I'm not time. Baby, that I'm not time. And I lose my mind tonight over you. Devil in a dress, I'ma love you like I do. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Follow the white rabbit to see the truth. Yeah, yeah. I'ma need to feel that, I'ma need to feel that too. Follow the white rabbit to see the truth, truth, truth.
Amazing. We loved it very much.
I think it's so rare to find an album like Life Support. It's a debut album that's so sonically and thematically and lyrically cohesive.
I feel like every show is just a complete new show. You come in, there's this magical moment, and basically you're with all of these people that you maybe have never met in your entire life, but you just all connect and you connect with Madison.
I know I do, I love you so much.
What do you want fans to take from coming to your shows? I just hope they ended up having fun, and I hope it was a night that they just got to dance around and be joyful and be with their friends. And I hope that I, you know, delivered a great show to them, and I hope they had fun, and I hope they know how grateful I am that they came out and, you know, just spent their night with me, truly. And I hope they feel less alone. If I can contribute anything positive to their lives or even just their night, that is all worth it to me.
This way. I'm not afraid to die.
life support means everything, you know, not only it being my first album, but this tour, everyone just being so receptive to my ideas that I thought were crazy, and the visuals and the outfits and everything, and people, you know, liking them. And I'm so grateful to every single person who came out, to every single person who wrote me a letter, gave me a gift, made me a sign, even just watched. Just you being in the room with me and sharing those moments, like, it's truly something that I will cherish for the rest of my life. Thank you.